Toposolid was introduced with the new release of Revit, Revit 2024. So now it has been a few months and the hype is over. So now it's time to explore how can you actually deal with toposolids and how can you achieve all of your design targets for modeling topography. Now to do so, I will use the environment plugin for Revit. With its latest version, environment for Revit is now compatible with Revit 2024 and it has quite a few new features and improvements. Today we're going to be reviewing only a couple of them working with the new toposolids. And by the way, with environment, you can easily switch between toposolids and toposurfaces, which is really important for maintaining your legacy projects. This is something that's not possible at all with native Revit. Let's go. Now, before we jump into Revit, if you want to check out the environment plugin, I'm going to be leaving a link for their free trial up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. And if you're interested in topography kind of in general, I have a whole course on site design and coordination in Revit on my website, balkanarchitect.com. Also something that I will link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. So when you install the environment plugin, it will appear over here as an extra tab. And here we have all of these tools which we can use mainly for topography, but for other uses as well. What I really like about the environment plugin is it has that approach to creating topography, which we had with the topo surfaces, where you can just place points and then the boundary will be generated according to kind of the outline of those points. And of course, you can create your own boundary if you want. Now for the first demonstration, I will show you how to create the topography kind of my favorite way with the environment plugin, and that's by using splines. So I, as an architect, tend to think about topography in terms of contour lines, and I like to draw out contour lines when I'm creating topography. So here, what I can do is go to the architecture tab and then just use the model line tool, just a regular model line tool. And I'm going to switch it to the spline just because that's kind of mostly resembling how you create topography. And then here I can just create some contour lines. Now here I have one and I'm just going to create a few more. Okay, so here we have a set of splines. So now what we'll be doing is go here to the environment tab and then I'm going to go to the model lines panel, and here I can actually set the elevation of these contour lines which I have created. So what I'll do is I'm going to start with the elevation of 0, add an increment of 1 meter, and then here I'm just going to set this to absolute elevation. Now to basically assign the elevation for these lines, I can go here to set elevation, and then I prefer using the set elevation by crossing, which allows me just to drag out one simple line and everything that intersects will kind of follow that. Now if I go to the 3D view and orbit around, now you can see that actually these are all set at different elevations, and now we can just simply turn these model lines into actual topography by going here to the topography tools, click on the edit topography tools, and then here I can create from line. So I'm just going to click on that, and basically we can just select all of these lines and it's going to generate points along each of those lines. And something that you'll notice is that it will optimize for the curvature. So where you have kind of more curvy lines, it's going to add more points, and then where you have these straight segments, it's going to add less points. And then here where we have a straight line, it's just one point in the beginning, one in the end, kind of keeping it all efficient. And now once we have all of these points here, I can just hit finish, and this will now turn this into topography. So I just need to click yes, and here we go. Now this is a toposolid topography. Now I can go back to the edit mode. So here, if I select this topography which we have created on the modified topo surface, you'll notice we now have these topography tools. So let's go back here to topography, and I just want to show you a few more features that we have here. So one feature that's extremely exciting is the topo surface topo solid toggle. So at any point you can toggle back to the original topo surfaces, or you can toggle back to topo solid. So it's actually just one click. I click here and hit finish. And now instead of a topo solid, we have a good old topo surface. And then again, I can select it, go here to topography tools, toggle that back on, hit finish, and now it's a topo solid. And you can do this for any topography at any time. Now I have switched this to realistic view mode and I have deleted those model lines because I no longer need them. And now I can select the topography and go to topography tools. And here I just want to show you that you can also adjust the main properties of this toposolid in this case. So I can just come in here and then I can go with a different one. So if I want to go with this grassland, I can apply that. Now, in addition to that, we can also play around with the boundary. So as I've mentioned in the beginning, we can adjust the boundary, or the boundary will be automatically created according to the outline of the points. However, you can sketch the boundary yourself. So I can go here to edit sketch, and then I can orbit around, kind of find a better view to look at this. And then what I can do here, let's create a smaller rectangle inside, just like this. And then I'm going to get rid of this larger one, hit finish, finish again, and now it's going to trim that toposolid. And now here we have a square. So this is what that looks like. Now this might seem quite ordinary, and if we select the topo surface here, we have the edit sketch, but actually something magical happened. So let me explain. What we have here is, if I go back to the topography tools, you'll notice that if I go to the top down view, we have basically points outside of our boundary. And now our topo surface, or topo solid, or just in general topography, because we can kind of switch backwards and forwards, well, it's still there. It's still the original surface, and that's used kind of as a reference surface, and then it's just trimmed down by the boundary. Now, this is something that may seem obvious, but actually with the regular edit boundary tool in Revit, we do not have this result. You cannot have points outside of the boundary of your topo solid. Now, this is really important because if I just finish out of this, and then if I go to modify sub-elements, what you'll notice here is that we have all of these points that have now appeared on the boundary in order to kind of shape the boundary of the topo solid. However, if I go back, so let me just go back here to kind of our original surface, which we had, like this. And then let's say I want to do the same thing by going here to edit sketch and then click continue here. And then let's create a sketch like this and delete the original one. Hit finish. This is what we have. See how it looks? Well, it looks terrible. So basically what Revit will do here, it will give us another boundary, but now when I go to modify sub-elements, it's not going to add any of those points at the boundary. So that's why the whole thing looks, well, flat at the edges, and it just doesn't look right. So by using that reference surface, which is a concept which we have inside of the environment plugin, we can keep the boundary looking exactly, well, how we generally intended to be. So I'm just going to go back a few steps and fix this terrible mistake. Now let's go back to our surface, and I'm just going to go here to topography tools, and then I'll go to edit sketch. And in this case, let's do something a bit more interesting than a square. So I'm just going to give it something a bit more complicated, like a circle. And then we can just get rid of the outside boundary and then hit finish, and let's see what this will look like now. And this is what we get. So it's a perfectly clean circle. And then if I select it and go to modify sub-elements, you can see kind of the environment working it all the way around with adding all of these additional points in order to make sure that that boundary looks the way it should. And it's not kind of bringing those points down at the edges, which definitely wouldn't look good. So that's basically how we can use this concept of reference surfaces in order to get the topography boundary that we're looking for. Okay, so now I'm going to be showing you some of my favorite topography tools. And for that, let's first create some topography. So I'm just going to go here to topography. And just to keep it simple, I'm going to be placing 4 points, which is going to give me a flat surface. Here in the main properties, let's make this grassland, hit apply, hit finish, and there we go. We have flat topography. Now, if I select this, what you'll see is here we have the modify topography tools, and this is what they find really exciting about the environment plugin, and this is what that looks like. So the first thing you'll notice here is it kind of looks like reference planes. Basically, it's like your surface has been cut with this basically grid. So what the environment will do is basically it will place a point at each intersection of this grid. Now, what I like to do is I like to make the cell size smaller. So let's try 2 meters, and that's going to smooth it out, give us more points. And then let me show you the mesh control. I really find this exciting. And here I like to go with the larger mesh. Yeah, this will work definitely. Okay, so basically you select one of the points and then you move them and it moves kind of this whole mesh. And this is really kind of organic, especially working in a 3D view. You can really see what's going on here and you can play around with that surface and you can shape it basically like clay any way you like it. So I really like this approach. Or basically kind of the user interface that's going on here and just how we can modify this topography. So there we go. Let's say we want to make something that looks like this. With these lines and points, we can kind of figure out what's going on and we can shape it. And once we're done, we can just apply those changes. And as you can see, the topography underneath has now been adapted to these points which we have changed. And now if I just click OK, now we have this topography which looks so smooth and it does look really natural, something that you would really have to work quite hard to get by placing points manually. Now, if I select this, if I go to modify sub-elements, what you'll see is we have that grid, which I have shown you in the beginning, and that's what's kind of shaping this whole surface. So now I'm just going to exit out of that. Now, to show you further what you can do is let's go back to modify topography, and it's going to give us the same grid here. And let's say I want to use shape by point. So what this will do is it will give you a shape size and a gain value. So when I come here close, you can see this kind of a star of points, and this can be adjusted, the size of this can be adjusted through the shape size, and I'm quite happy with the size here. And then here we have the gain value, so how much gain or elevation gain will you have at that place or at kind of the highest point. So here it's set to 1.5. I'm happy with that. So now if I click, it's going to just bring it up. So this looks kind of like Sims, you know, where you can just click and it brings up and gives it gain value of 1.524 at that place. So it's a really easy and intuitive way to play around with your topography. Now, also, if at any point you would like to smooth out your surface, you can go here to smooth geometry, add a smoothing level. So let's try 3, I don't know, and then apply changes. And it's just going to make those lines a little bit smoother. And of course, by increasing the cell size, you can get more points. More points obviously means more smoothness. And now I'm just going to OK out of this. Now, finally, I just want to show you one more cool trick. And here we have a floor, some concrete, and let's say I want to have some topography in the middle. So what I'll do is I'm just going to go here to environment, go to topography tools, and then I'm going to go with from edge. So now I can just pick out these two edges and it's going to give me a set of points on each of those. I can even give them a height offset. So usually you're going to have the earth and the grass a little bit lower below the kind of sidewalk. So in this case, I can give it a -0.2 or -0.1 height offset. So as you can see, the points are now 10 centimeters below. And then let's insert those points. So basically we have some topography there, and then let's change this to grassland, hit apply. Finish. So there we go. We have now flat topography there. Now, flat topography is boring and it usually doesn't look very natural. Usually ground isn't completely flat. Well, you do have to do quite a lot of work to get it like that. So to make it a bit more interesting, let's inflate this surface. So what I'll do is I'm just going to select it, go to modify topography. And then here for the cell size, this being just a small piece of topography, let's make it 1 meter, so we have a lot more points. So now let's go here to inflate surface, and I'm just going to give it a little bit. So let's try with 4 and see what that gives us. So now, yeah, the surface is now inflated just a little bit, and it's going to look a lot more natural than it would if it was kind of completely flat. And now if I select it and go to modify sub-elements, you can see we have all of these points, and you can see when you kind of orbit around, we get a little bit of inflation of those points. So I think this looks a lot more natural than it did when it was completely flat. So there you go. That concludes everything for this tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed it, and I'm going to be making more tutorials on the environment tools in the future. As I said, if you want to check it out, the link will be in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.